plastic one. The yeah. Like this on it though.
Yeah.
This one looks so good.
Yeah.
You look a lot better, brother.
Thank you.
I'm glad we met up today.
Hey, Sawyer, it's Daddy. This is Daddy's good friend, George Collins. George Collins is 92 years old. He's almost 100 years old. Daddy comes over and helps him out every day with his memory. Him and then I come over and help James, who has, he's deaf, so I help him out with sign language. Say hi, George.
Hi,
Sawyer.
Sawyer, good to see you. I hope I can see you, darling, but I just can't get there. I'm not mobile. That's my problem. I'm just a little too old.
You're not old.
But James has helped me a lot. He's
Do you enjoy the help of the memory? Has it been helping?
Yeah, he's a good kid, and he's doing everything he can to help an old man. But I hope we get. I hope it was somehow possible we could meet. But if not, just I want you to know that I love you and I love James, and God bless both of you.
Thank you, George. Show me those teeth.
That's Mike, right?
Yep, that's Mike.
The happiest groom.
I see trees of green.
He really was.
Red roses too.
That's Christine's husband, Mike.
I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
It's Mike and his best man.
Yeah.
I see skies of blue.
That's Mike and all the grooms right there at Christine's wedding.
Yeah, that's great.
This is George's favorite memory.
Yep.
The dark sacred night.
Great picture.
There's George's daughter, Christine Sawyer. Isn't she beautiful? Look how beautiful she is, baby.
The colors of the rainbow, so pretty.
That's Christine and her friend. She was the bridesmaid. That's Dorothea and Christine. That's George's wife right there. And that's George's daughter. Aren't they beautiful women? George and Christine. Look how happy he is. Biggest smile in the world. That's George right now.
Greatest feeling in the world.
There's Christine, Sawyer. She's beautiful, huh?
Yeah. This is a better day to Christmas.
This is what George's favorite memory. He did the whole wedding for Christine. The whole town showed up. It was a standing room only at the cathedral for Christine and Mike's wedding.
Happiest wedding anybody ever saw in the
life. Yeah, George just does a good job. And it's Christine. Christine was allowed behind the altar, which isn't allowed, but they let her behind the altar.
Let me cross yourself with the cross.
I see them blue.
Yeah. Isn't he handsome, Sawyer? Look at me, George. Smile. Isn't he handsome? He's 92 years old. He's almost 100 years old. I like how handsome his smile is.
Huh. Yeah, keep going. Keep going. It's all the bridesmaids and the bride and all the groomsmen and the groom Mike. This is Mike and Christine's wedding.
I'm glad you found this.
Yeah.
The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky.
It's all the wedding party right there.
Also on the faces of people going by.
Daddy helps George every day. George is really old, so his memory is really bad. So Daddy goes over memories with him every day. All these pictures, he's getting all his memories back.
Yeah.
That's Christine and Mike right there. Look at how happy she is. Sawyer, isn't she happy? She's pretty too. She's been doing her husband and wife dance. Keep going. Pretty happy that day.
Oh,
and there's,
well, we're all happy.
There's George and Christine. Was that the father-daughter dance?
Yeah, well, were you ever happy that day? That was the happiest day of my life.
It looks like it, George. I see trees of green. Mike and Christine. Red roses too. Don't worry about those. I see them blue. Keep going in the wedding. Keep going on the wedding. What a wonderful world. Anyway, that's George's favorite memory. He paid for the whole wedding. He paid for the whole wedding. It was a standing room only. Everybody in the town came. The whole choir showed up. Christine got left behind the altar, which isn't allowed in their church. But they let her on that day because it was a special wedding day. And George paid for it all. George used to be a big real estate guy. He owned all kinds of properties. George, smile. There's George. Sexiest 92-year-old I know. He's 92 years old, Sawyer. But he's handsome. That's George's great-grandson, Makai, of the sea. That's what his name means, of the sea. He's a handsome little dude, isn't he? How old is Makai? Probably like 7 or 8 or something. I met him that one time, yeah, he's pretty old.
He's bringing all those items back to bear, back to mind. And that's important to me. And I feel now that with James's assistance and James to guide me, and believe me, James's help to no end, my mindset is going to be much settled now. Well, I hope so, because when you reach my age, it's... It's getting to the point where it's almost ridiculous.
92 years young, George. I mean,
nobody is supposed to be this old.
But you did it, George.
I did it. And with James's assistance and James's contributions. Who knows? I could be one of those rare birds that really go into the stratosphere.
Well, you're a rare bird, all right? With a pretty smile.
So anyway, nice talking to you.
Show your smile. There's that smile. I love you, George. You're my best friend in the world.
Nice talking to you, my friend.
George, does my help with your memory? It helps a lot?
It helps my memory tremendously.
Okay. Yeah, I know you've been getting all these cool memories back, George. It's been gone forever.
I know it. But this helps me so much.
I come over every day and I review pictures with George of all his great achievements and his memories. And he's lost all his memories. He had a bad surgery. He's lost them for 40 years. Didn't remember people's names or anything. Now he's getting all these memories back because we review these memories every day. I hope George, and he's doing such a good job. Not too bad for 92, man. Your handsome smile. Isn't George handsome? Oh, man. So it does help you with your memories?
James has helped me tremendously. Without James, I don't know what I would have done.
You're my best friend.
I don't know what I would have done without James.
Oh, man.
James Votaw, to me, is a genuine hero.
I love you, buddy.
God bless him. God bless him.
I want to be in my daughter's life, George.
He has to be in his daughter's life. He has to be.
Cassie will not let me be a part of her life at all.
She's wrong.
She's so wrong. I was such a bad guy. I was a horrible guy. I was a devil when I was married to her. But I'm not that guy anymore.
No.
And she won't even pay attention to that.
This is a hero. This man is a hero.
Yeah. You're God a hero, George. You're a God Korean God. War vet. You 92-year-old beautiful man. Oh, this is my best buddy in the world. Yeah?
No, I'm sure. Yeah, definitely his best friend.
Yeah, George loves.
And I'm looking at his picture right now.
This is George's favorite picture of Daddy. When I was a sniper in Cuba. And this picture, Sawyer, I was doing a sniper, and I was looking after the Colonel of America and the General of Cuba, where the base is with all the bad guys. This is me doing the Overwatch and protecting the American colonel and the Cuban general. I was protecting the colonel to make sure none of the Cubans did anything to him. This is George's favorite picture in the world. This is the cover for Daddy's book. I'm going to put so many pictures of me and you, but that's Daddy's cover for his book. Is that cool, Sawyer? Oh, buddy. I love that picture. I was gonna use another picture, but you're right. That's my picture. I want to use a picture of me and my daughter for the cover, but
that is
I'm gonna put so many pictures of me and my daughter in there.
Yes.
My ex-wife, she always tells me, your daughter hates you. She can't stand your face. You disgust. You make her sick to your stomach. I showed you all the pictures of me and my daughters with the biggest smile on her face.
Yeah.
Yeah, tell family court that.
Yeah.
Oh, buddy. Anyway, I love my daughter. My ex-wife followed me to be a part of her life. I'm surprised.
James Votaw is a winner.
So I have a question, George. Do you think I'm a good father? Do you think I should be in Sawyer's life?
You definitely should be in Sawyer's life. You're a good father, and not only that, you're a good man.
I appreciate that.
And you're a man's man.
I appreciate that. My problem was the drugs. I used to be on drugs with my ex-wife. So, I mean, I did some stuff to her that deserves for me not to, to be a part of my daughter's life, for sure. But I survived.
We have certain items that possibly should not have been a part of our life, but they were and they are.
And they were.
Yeah. But the thing is, act like a man, and yeah, you're acting like a man, and you are a man.
I appreciate that. I mean, that's my biggest thing. I want to be in my daughter's life right now. My ex-wife will not let that happen.
No.
So, I mean, I deserve the stuff I put them through. I deserve not to be in my daughter's life, but...
Yes, you do. You don't take that attitude for even the slightest second.
I know. Slightest
second.
I know. I'm not that same person I used to be.
Well...
I do a lot.
You deserve to be in your wife's memory, and by God, you're there.
Yeah.
And you act like a man, and you are a man.
I appreciate it, George.
This is bringing all those items back to bear, back to mind, and that's important to me.
I'm glad, George.
And I feel now that with James's assistance, and James to guide me, And believe me, James has helped to no end. My mindset is going to be much settled now.
Well, you've been doing so much better, George.
Well, I hope so, because when you reach my age, it's getting to the point where it's almost ridiculous.
92 years young, George.
I mean, nobody is supposed to be this old.
But you did it, George.
I did it. And with James's assistance and James's contributions, who knows? I could be one of those rare birds that really go into the stratosphere.
You're a rare bird, all right. With a pretty smile.
So anyway, nice talking to you.
Share your smile. There's that smile. I love you, George. You're my best friend in the world.
Nice talking to you, my friend.
This is George Sawyer, my cool 92-year-old friend with a pretty smile. Hello, everybody. All right.
The best guy in the world, Sawyer.
This is Daddy's best friend, George Collins. He's 92 years old. He's almost 100 years old. Isn't he handsome, Sawyer?
I'm 93, Sawyer. Don't believe him.
93 years young.
Oh, yeah.
All right, love you, buddy. Have a good day.
That's Mike, right?
Yep, that's Mike.
The happiest groom.
I see trees of green. He really was. Red
roses too. That's Christine's husband, Mike.
What a wonderful world.
It's Mike and his best man.
Yeah. I see skies of blue.
That's Mike and all the grooms right there at Christine's wedding.
Yeah, that's great.
This is George's favorite memory.
Yep. The dark sacred night. Great picture.
There's George's daughter, Christine Sawyer. Isn't she beautiful? Look how beautiful she is, baby.
The colors of the rainbow, so pretty.
That's Christine and her friend. She was the bridesmaid. That's Dorothea and Christine. That's George's wife right there. That's George's daughter. Aren't they beautiful women? Look how happy he is, biggest smile in the world. That's George right now.
Greatest feeling in the world.
That's Christine Sawyer. She's beautiful, huh?
Yeah.
This is
a better picture.
This is George's favorite memory. He did the whole wedding for Christine. The whole town showed up. Was a standing room only at the cathedral for Christine and Mike's wedding.
Happiest wedding anybody ever saw in the
life. Yeah, George just does a good job. And it's Christine. Christine was allowed behind the altar, which isn't allowed, but they let her behind the altar.
Let me cross yourself with the cross.
I see them bloom.
Yeah. Isn't he handsome, Sawyer? Look at me, George. Smile. Isn't he handsome? He's 92 years old. He's almost 100 years old. I like how handsome his smile is. Keep going.
It's all the bridesmaids and the bride and all the groomsmen and the groom Mike. This is Mike and Christine's wedding.
I'm glad you found this. Right around.
Yeah.
The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky.
It's all the wedding party right there.
Also on the faces of people going by.
Daddy helps George every day. George is really old, so his memory is really bad. So Daddy goes over memories with him every day. All these pictures, he's getting all his memories back.
Yeah.
That's Christine and Mike right there. Look at how happy she is. Sawyer, isn't she happy? She's pretty too. And then doing her husband and wife dance. Keep going. Pretty happy that day.
Oh,
there's,
well, we're all happy.
There's George and Christine. Was that the father-daughter dance?
Yeah, well, were you ever happy that day? Never the happiest day of my life.
It looks like it, George. I see trees of green. Mike and Christine. Red roses too. Don't worry about those. I see them blue. Keep going, the wedding. Keep going on the wedding. What a wonderful world. Anyway, that's George's favorite memory. He paid for the whole wedding. He paid for the whole wedding. It was a standing room only. Everybody in the town came. The whole choir showed up. Christine got left behind the altar, which isn't allowed in the church, but they let her on that day because it was a special wedding day. And George paid for it all. George used to be a big real estate guy. He owned all kinds of properties. George, smile. There's George. Sexiest 92-year-old I know. He's 92 years old, Sawyer. But he's handsome. That's George's great-grandson, Makai, of the sea. That's what his name means, of the sea. He's a handsome little dude, isn't he? How old is Makai? Probably like 7 or 8 or something. I met him that one time. Yeah, he's pretty old.
He's bringing all those items back to bear, back to mind. And it's important to me. And I feel now that with James's assistance and James to guide me, and believe me, James's help to no end, my mindset is going to be much settled now. Well, I hope so, because when you reach my age, it's... It's getting to the point where it's almost ridiculous.
92 years young, George. I mean,
nobody is supposed to be this old.
But you did it, George.
I did it. And with James's assistance and James's contributions. Who knows? I could be one of those rare birds that really go into the stratosphere.
Well, you're a rare bird, all right? With a pretty smile.
So anyway, nice talking to you.
Share your smile. There's that smile. I love you, George. You're my best friend in the world.
Nice talking to you, my friend.
Have a good night, brother. On the left?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. How old is she?
She's 27.
Okay. Yeah, she's cute. There you go. Let's go. Trade it for that one. For that one. Yeah, we'll go down to the gas station. You say you don't have any other raises? That's all I have. Man. Oh, man. No. You just go to a gas station and fucking, it's free.
Yeah. You're looking a lot better, brother.
Okay.
I'm glad we met up today.
Yeah. Like this on it though?
Yeah.
This thing looks so good. Yeah. This guy, Vin James, at Walmart. He's a homeless drug addict, lost his wife and his daughter to drugs and homelessness. He was turned into a shot of speed. I watched him for 12 hours trying to hide it. I walked up to him and I said, "Hey, brother, I'll like, put the needle down. I'll change your life right now." He looked at me and said, "F you. What the hell would you know about my life? You're all clean shaven, dressed nice, talking well. What the hell would you know about my life? I lost my wife and my daughter to this bullshit." He said, "Wow, brother, I'm so sorry I judged you." He pulled the needle out of his arm and shot all the speed against a wall and said, "If you think you can help me, I'm willing to try." Now when I call him, he's too busy because he's with his girlfriend. He's like, "I'm busy, I'm with my girlfriend." I was like, "Oh, thanks, buddy." Homeless drug addict lost speed. Lost his wife and his daughter to drugs and homelessness. 24 hours later, Benjamin James Price. I have a date with my ex-wife and my daughter. Thank you, James. I appreciate it so much.
You know, we'll go down to the gas station. You say you don't have any other raises? That's all I have. Man.
George, you can't drink that. That's detergent. I'd kill you if you drink that. You can't drink that, buddy.
Hi, Sawyer. It's your dad's friend.
That's my friend, Jill.
He helps me a lot. He helps everyone a lot. You're a lucky girl. I hope you know, your dad helps everyone.
Does it help you when we do the mirror box?
Yes.
Show her how it works.
So, they're all putting my hand in here.
What's up?
They're all putting my hand in here.
Yeah. She's paralyzed
on
her.
It's complicated.
What's up?
It's sort of complicated.
That's okay. She's 8 now. Ken says she can understand it.
Yeah. Oh, I can understand.
So
of course she can.
Jill's paralyzed on the left side of your body, right?
Yeah.
So Jill uses her right hand in the mirror, and it looks like it's her right hand moving or her left hand moving. So it tricks her brain into thinking that her left arm's moving, so it starts teaching her brain how to work her left arm again.
My brain forgot.
Yeah, Jill's brain forgot how to tell her arm how to move. So Daddy helps her out with this mirror box, and it's reteaching her brain how to move her left arm.
Daddy.
She looks in the mirror with her left or her right arm, and she makes a motion, and it looks like, in the mirror, it looks like her so other arm is doing it. So it starts tricking her brain into thinking her other arm's moving.
Up like this?
So it starts helping her arm move again.
Down like that.
I've been friends with Jill for a long time. She has an injury like Daddy in the brain. Smile, Jill.
And I guess...
No, you didn't. All right.
Thank you.
It's a lot harder to do. I know.
I know.
I was doing it really bad for you. Not doing anything for your teeth either. So.
Yeah, implants from anything.
Huh?
If we implant from anything. No grill. No better than that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You said, what was your name again?
Wade.
James, man. Hey, have a good day. Enjoy that stuff, man. How's for being in the fucking bin and show up again? You're ready to get off of speed and get back on your feet and off of drugs and get your life back together? Call me. You saw what I did for that guy, Ben. He was a wreck. It took me one day. And you saw how he looked after he shaved and I gave him some clothes and showered him. This morning he called me, I'm at my girl's house. Sorry, I can't come. I was like, oh, really? Make sure that your girl said thank you to me. I mean, just, if you're ready, get your life back together, dog.
That makes you paranoid.
What's up?
That makes you paranoid.
Yeah. Speed makes you more paranoid.
No.
Sure, I haven't been there before. Anyway, if you're ready to get your fucking life back together, call me. You have my number. I'll help you out.
But the thing is, act like a man, and you're acting like a man, and you are a man.
I appreciate that. I mean, that's my biggest thing. I want to be in my daughter's life right now. My ex-wife will not let that happen.
No.
So, I mean, I deserve the stuff I put them through. I deserve not to be in my daughter's life, but...
No, yes, you do. You don't take that attitude for even the slightest second.
I know.
Slightest second.
I know. I'm not that same person I used to be.
Well...
I do a lot.
You deserve to be in your wife's memory, and by God, you're there.
Yeah.
And you act like a man, and you are a man.
I appreciate it, George.
James Wartaw is a winner.
So I have a question, George. Do you think I'm a good father? Do you think I should be in Sawyer's life?
You definitely should be in Sawyer's life. You're a good father, and not only that, you're a good man.
I appreciate that.
And you're a man's man.
My problem was the drugs. I used to be on drugs with my ex-wife. So, I mean, I did some stuff to her that deserves for me not to be a part of my daughter's life, for sure. But I survived.
We have certain items that possibly should not have been a part of our life, but they were and they are.
Hi, Claire. See Daddy's friend.
This is Jill, Daddy's friend. I help her out every day.
Yeah.
Does it help you when I help you out with the mirror box?
Yes.
Do I help a couple people?
Your daddy helps everyone.
Yeah, I help everyone, Sawyer. A lot of people.
You are a lucky girl.
You hear that, Sawyer? You're a lucky girl.
You're a lucky ninja.
Hey, she said you're a ninja. I told her about your ninja story at Christmas. You really are a ninja, Sawyer.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is Jill. Jill had a brain injury like Daddy, and it left her paralyzed, so she can't use her arm or her leg. Her brain forgot how to tell her arm or her leg how to move. So Daddy works with her every day, and it's helping her a lot. I mean, I try to help her every day. Me and Jill are friends. Right?
Yes.
All right. Okay, this is Jill. This is Daddy's friend, Jill.
Yeah. Hi, Sawyer. Happy birthday.
Isn't she beautiful? Smile. All right, thank you, Joe.
Anytime.
This is George Sawyer, my cool 92-year-old friend. Was a pretty smile. Hello, everybody. All right.
The best guy in the world, Sawyer.
This is Daddy's best friend, George Collins. He's 92 years old. He's almost 100 years old. Isn't he handsome, Sawyer?
I'm 93, Sawyer. Don't believe him.
93 years young.
Oh, yeah.
All right. All right. Love everybody. Okay. Have a good day.
Instead of merely holding conversation,
bringing all those items back to bear, back to mind, and that's important to me.
I'm glad, George.
And I feel now that with James's assistance and James to guide me, and believe me, James's help to no end, My mindset is going to be much settled now.
Well, you've been doing so much better, George.
Well, I hope so, because when you reach my age, it's getting to the point where it's almost ridiculous.
92 years young, George.
I mean, nobody is supposed to be this old.
But you did it, George.
I did it. And with James's assistance and James's contributions. Who knows? I could be one of those rare birds that really go into the stratosphere.
You're a rare bird, all right. With a pretty smile.
So anyway, nice talking to you.
Share your smile. There's that smile. I love you, George. You're my best friend in the world.
Nice talking to you, my friend.
Who? The eagle.
The eagle. Isn't that nice to me?
From me to
you. That's my son. You kiss him.
I said,
you're kidding me.
He's the eagle.
Oh, that's my son, the eagle.
Yeah. Can't believe you met the eagle singer, George.
He's the eagle.
You've done so much in your life, buddy. I'm proud of you. Pretty good day. Looks warm. Weather's warm.
Here, yeah,
look like an old man.
With droopy ears.
I look like that.
I said, I had no backup. You know,
let go.
You had been here, you know, I could have made the argument, I had some backup.
I would be here, but Pastor Rico won't move me back.
No, I'm just saying.
Yeah, I know, I would have had you back.
I'm all alone. Son of a bitch, I'm in dire straits here.
I would have had your back on and jogged over and beat him up.
Oh, man.
So,